Hey guys, it has been a while since I have done a Facebook Live, and that's partially because Facebook has been censoring, obviously, a lot, and banning my posts and limiting my reach because they do not want the truth to get out about a lot of things. So I will start the video by saying, please share. It's the only way that we can stop the Facebook censorship that is going on and that we can communicate with one another. I will also say, if you have not yet, please download and make the jump to Parler, because we know that's a company that does not engage in censorship and is not a part of the big tech collusion. Okay, so if you guys have been watching my new show at the Daily Wire, you know that I am starting to, I'm trying to slowly unpack China for a lot of viewers because I've realized that there is a huge deficit in terms of what America knows about China, and that is very intentional. Right now in school, you are learning about critical race theory, you are learning about all of these genders, and no one is actually talking about foreign policy or teaching our children history, which is why, most importantly, be sure to share this video with your children. Make sure that young people see this video. If you're a young person, share this video because it's really important. And I'm gonna try to go slowly and try to keep this under 10 minutes. So the first thing that you need to know is that we live in modern times. You might go, that's very obvious, but there's a lot of stuff that comes with living in modern times. The first thing is that there's no longer, especially in the West, there's no longer a ground for people to invade countries in the way that they used to, meaning that you're not going to see in modern times tanks rolling into America and people trying to take over America, very obviously, right? So any form of trying to take down a country is going to be very tacit, it's going to be very slow, and it's going to never look like an attack. Hence the reason why so many people instantly thought that COVID-19 was a bioweapon. It was remarkably convenient, and we know that China gained a lot from COVID-19 and Western civilization lost a lot during COVID-19. That would be a concept that would happen today in terms of how you would attack a country, right? It can't be, hey, China's going to gear up and land on American soil and start telling, you know, invading, knocking down doors and invading people that way. It's going to be very tacit, very quiet. Something like a bioweapon makes sense. So in terms of all of the cultural Marxism that we're seeing today, and when I talk about cultural Marxism, I'm talking about what I brought up earlier in terms of what's going on in our classrooms, in terms of these protests that we're seeing that seem insane. You couldn't even fathom this a decade ago. You couldn't fathom a time where it was considered a crime to say that only women can give birth, or that's considered bigoted. A lot of this is actually an attack on America, and it's important that you understand that China is behind a lot of it. China, for those of you that don't know, and you should actually look it up, has had a plan that was intercepted by the CIA years ago. China has had a 100-year plan to take over the world, right? Those are their ambitions. And the idea is that by 2049, which will be the centennial anniversary of Mao and all that he tried to do, the CCP, they want to make sure that they are globally in a position where they are a global world power to the West, but is looking to the East and looking to China. Just understand that basic idea, that China has had this plan, they are implementing this plan. And while you're not learning about what's happening in the South China Sea, they began implementing this plan just by taking control of the South China Sea. For those of you that don't know, maritime trade is so important, right? So just ships being able to move products back and forth, right? If there is a country that can control shipping, they can virtually control the world, or at least control very important elements of it. And this is why there has been so much friction in that region. All of these Asian countries saying, look over here, China is trying to take over the South China Sea. China said, we have historical claim to the sea, and that is what matters, and this sea is ours. In reality, they just want to control the South China Sea, and they have been effective. They literally used coral reef that was in the South China Sea to build themselves a military base. There was not an island there, and they literally built an island there, and they now control an entire military base in the South China Sea by the Spratly Islands. You should look that up. It is very important to understand that 33% of the world's maritime trade goes through the South China Sea, and they now effectively control it. What China has understood about the West in terms of how to weaken the West is that our weakness is that Americans love money, right? Americans, free market, capitalist society, people want to enrich their pockets. The entrepreneurial spirit wants to get to America to make money. And that is how they have played us. They said, okay, what we'll do is we'll just give them what they want in the short term, which is money. And we will look at the industries that have the most impact in America, and we will offer those industries money. So one element that I'm talking about is that over the last couple of decades, China has virtually taken over Hollywood, right? So you are never going to hear LeBron James speak out on the atrocities of China, even though he's got a sponsorship with Nike. It would seem like common sense for someone like LeBron James, who is passionately talking about racism and talking about oppression, to obviously take up an issue with Nike and the having a deal with China and the children slaves that they have. Beyond that, they actually have genocidal camps, the Muslim camps, and you're not even allowed to say this on most platforms. You should look into the camps that they have, which they call re-education camps for Muslims. You never hear anybody talk about that at all, and you don't hear our media talk about it. Our media is compromised and taking money from China. Big tech, you don't hear them talking about it. They don't want that to get out. And you, again, don't hear the athletes in Hollywood. They control a lot of the film industry. They started doing deals when our film industries were sinking. I know this because I worked in private equity. And during that time, the company that I was working for was investing a lot of money into films and working in distressed debt, and the film industry was in a lot of debt. And China stepped in and said, we will put up money to buy a lot of these Hollywood film companies, and they did just that. So they are controlling our media, they have money within the sports industry. So all of the idols are working for China, whether they know it or not, right? They know what they can't say, and they have them super focused. There are ties via the Black Lives Matter movement to China. They're putting money into making sure that America is focused on race as they quietly attempt to take over the world. Okay. Something else that you should find to be very interesting: China has a lot of money and our educators are stupid. Beyond that, they are, you know, we have people that are so focused on gender. Well, think about this. This is super interesting. You can look it up. You can read it in the BBC. At the same time that America is focused on all of these genders, right, on saying there's 26 genders, all this lunacy that's going on, by saying, oh, we're going to recognize all these genders, by saying that men need to act more effeminate, right? That we don't, the concept of masculinity is wrong and backwards, and the progressives are saying this is a way forward. China is putting together a pro-masculinity program in their country, right? So America is trying to turn our men into women, while China is trying to make their men more manly. There's literally a masculinity program going on in China to make men more manly. Think about that. Actually focus. You might be watching this and thinking, Candace, I absolutely hate you and I'm a Democrat and I voted for Biden and all of these things. Do you not find that to be odd that a country which is trying, which has ambition to take over the world, is trying to inflame race rhetoric in our country and trying to pretend that America is not woke enough, while at the same time not allowing one drop of that wokeness into their own country? This is a country that has gained under the COVID-19 stuff. They are the only country that did well financially during the, you know, the COVID-19 lockdowns, where they locked down for approximately 2 weeks and then they were back to normal, throwing parties in Wuhan, while the West suffered, right? So they are completely behind this effort to make sure that we render the men in America weaker. They control the media, and you may have heard, you know, the whole Beijing Biden, obviously, the reason why our press censored all the Hunter Biden emails and the Hunter Biden texts is because what they reveal is that Hunter Biden has had a long-standing relationship along with his father, who he brought into the deals with Burisma and with China. So China, our president is compromised by China. There is no question about this. If you need to know that, then you need to just look into the text messages and the emails and the meetings that Biden took, and the reason why people were calling him Beijing Biden, and the reason why he refuses to speak out against the CCP or say anything negative about the CCP is because he wants to make sure that, you know, he does his job. Like, his job is to make sure, again, that America is compromised by China, because that is what enriches his pockets. That is what enriches the Democrats' pockets, is to essentially sell out our country. Now, when I say Democrats, I'm not talking about you, the Democrat voter. I don't think most Democrat voters are evil. I think they're severely misinformed and don't understand that the politicians that they support are compromised by China. Now I'm going to make it make sense to you for why the Democrats have been ruthlessly attacking Trump supporters. Keep in mind, Trump has been awake to the threat of China. Trump is a businessman. He understands how odd it is that all of our products in America are made in China. You may be going, oh, it's just because things are cheaper. Well, it doesn't matter. It does matter. That means China could shut down trade, right? China could say, we're giving you no products, and China could economically weaken America overnight. They could just make decisions and wipe all of the stuff from Americans. The jobs are being sent overseas, right? So we are directly tied and reliant upon, increasingly more reliant upon the Chinese for money. Trump understood this. He said, nope, bring the jobs back home. He said, we're going to start a tariff war with China. And this became an existential threat to China and their global ambitions, right? So if you are China and accidentally Trump becomes president because it wasn't meant to happen, and he keeps talking about China, 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 and they were trying to be like the sleeping silent dragon, right? And you see that Trump is suddenly starting to talk about China, and you realize that your plans, which the Democrats are on board with, are now being impacted. You need to do everything in your power to make sure that you can, that Trump gets out of office very quickly, that you keep harping on that race narrative, that you call your media people, your Hollywood 150 people, you know, that some of them who didn't have, had nothing on them, literally took a selfie. They're still in prison, sitting in solitary confinement in a cell in Washington, D.C. They are federal, literal, political prisoners. You're going to tell me that Antifa and Black Lives Matter burned down churches and they were released on bail, and these people for taking selfies, literally, there are people that are in there for taking selfies in the Capitol that are in solitary confinement. That is a way to lock up political dissidents. That is a way to prime us for a totalitarian regime. Now, this last aspect is something that I have put together, which seems like common sense. You may have noticed the recent Asian Lives Matter campaign. So random, right? By the way, guys, if you haven't yet, quick pause, if you're watching this and you haven't yet subscribed to my show, please do. I'm talking about all this important stuff, and we have to start creating our own media. We can't keep relying on Facebook to communicate. And I'm talking about all of this stuff on my show with Daily Wire. You can literally use my code, which is Chrissy, C-H-R-I-S-S-Y, and you can get 20% off of your new membership. I really think it's important that we meet on different mediums, and it's why I joined Daily Wire. You guys might be annoyed that there is a paywall, but like, we don't have control of this media. Facebook is censoring my posts. Please hit share, because this is probably the most important live I've ever done, because people need to start putting the pieces together. So again, code Chrissy, C-H-R-I-S-S-Y, dailywire.com/subscribe. I hope by the end of this, all 20,000 of you watching will become members, because I'm really doing important work in terms of educating everybody about what is happening right now in our country. Okay, now back to understanding the Asian Lives Matter campaign. You may have thought that was random, like Asian Lives Matter out of nowhere. Like, again, Hollywood, brought to you by Hollywood. Something happens. There was obviously an awful incident where somebody shot up in an Asian spa. Oh my God, this is because of white supremacy. Completely ridiculous. Obviously, the person I met, they had a porn addiction. The spa happened to have all Asian people, but he did not kill them for being Asian. They just happened to be the people that were operating this, you know, spa, right? But they started harping on this, and suddenly you started seeing people in Hollywood, again, Hollywood controlled by China, starting this Asian Lives Matters campaign, and the Democrats started demanding to pass through legislation to protect Asian lives. Where is that going, right? We know, like, in this country, like, it was the most random thing. Like, first and foremost, if you're looking at statistics, Black Americans are the people that are attacking Asian lives in general. They're a very small piece of the population, Asians, and yet this campaign overnight appeared. Well, what's obviously going to happen, and what the Democrats and China are working on in terms of that campaign, is to criminalize speaking out against Asian people. They're going to basically start to say that a post like this, what Candace is doing, is a form of Asian hate. Right? And if China is going to take over the West, then China needs to make sure that political dissidents or people like me cannot speak out against China. So they're going to try to criminalize any speech against China. You saw this even early on with, we need to stop calling it the Chinese virus. That's a form of racism. Like, no, it's not. You call it the German measles. You call it the Spanish flu. We should be able to call it the Chinese COVID, you know, the Chinese virus. I mean, this is just what we've done since forever, but suddenly it became not okay when it became about Chinese people, right? And the purpose of that, again, if you're a Chinese American, you don't care if it's called the Chinese virus. There's all sorts of things that are called the African variant, the Indian variant. Nobody cared until China cared. And this is actually going to be a very slow decline. My post when I tried to share it, that's very interesting. Let me know if you guys are able to share this. This is going to be, the Asian Lives Matter campaign is the beginning, because China is very brilliant at playing this slow game. They are very patient. Americans are not patient. This is going to be the beginning of a crime, and are going to start holding them responsible for things, because they have noticed that Twitter, also compromised by China, is allowing all of this anti-Indian government sentiment. Well, that's because the Indian government is extremely conservative and China does not control them. Again, a next door neighbor labor, and you've got a population that is going to surpass China's probably in the next 10 years. I think there are 1.3 billion, don't quote me on that, of people that are next door. So they are wedged between, if you are China, you are being touched by North Korea, you are being touched by North Korea, which again, Trump was going to do, went over and met with Kim Jong-un, again, a guard against China, and you were being touched by Russia, and you were being touched by India. So all of these attacks in our media, how focused big tech seems to be on spinning a web of lies about India, about spinning a web of lies about Vladimir Putin. Again, not saying he's a saint, but I am saying he's not a threat to Americans at this point in time. It's all because it helps China. So every time you look at anything that's happening in America, I want to do this video to remind you to think, how does this benefit China? How did the Black Lives Matter campaign benefit China, and why do they put dollars behind it? How is Facebook benefiting China? How is the narrative against Vladimir Putin benefiting China? How is COVID-19 benefiting China economically? How is it possible that COVID-19 represented one of the biggest wealth transfers that's ever taken place? Now they're reporting that they don't even know where half of that money went, and that they believe it went to foreign agents. My guess is going to be that it will be interpreted down the line that a lot of that money that our government's, you know, seized and transferred went to China, and the Democrats are implicit in all of this. They are taking a lot of money from China right now, and at the end of the day, it's not because they care about the country, it's just that they care about money more. If you have any questions, yes, I believe that China has, people that are asking, has China helped Biden to become president? I think it's very obvious that, you know, if you read the emails that the media refuses to cover, that China had a very real interest in both Hillary Clinton and Biden winning, because Democrats have been compromised by China for a very long time. Guys, share this before it becomes a crime. Again, I am begging you to go to dailywire.com/subscribe. Use my coupon code, which is Chrissy, to get a percentage off of your new membership, and to watch my show that comes out every Tuesday night. We talked about China this week. I sat down with Jack Posobiec, and we just unpacked foreign policy, which you are not hearing in the classrooms. They are trying to weaken our country from the inside out. Hollywood is implicit, the Democrats are implicit, and we are really, really close to being too far, and we will not be able to pull this thing back. China is very, very scary right now. Do not allow them to make you think it is Russia. It is not Russia. It is not Vladimir Putin. Trump should have done a deal with them to protect us against China. Again, dailywire.com/subscribe. Please comment if you did subscribe after this. I hope that you all did. I hope there's 20,000 subscriptions. Code Chrissy, Chrissy, dailywire.com/subscribe. Code Chrissy. I love you guys. Please share this video because it matters.